Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. In today's program, I'm going to be talking about Linux and why it is really cool stuff. Again, I'm sure you guys have never heard me talk about Linux on this channel, but if you have, congratulations, you've been here for a while. So, I want to talk to you about some more reasons I like Linux. I did a video on this, what was it, 2 or 3 years ago? Okay, well, for one thing, we've got to talk about containers. I've gotten really into Docker containers lately, and you could argue that is very heavily, I mean, you can do that on other systems, but it's really a Linux thing more than anything. So you got to thank Linux for containers, and so many things run through containers, things like PayPal, all these different big companies, they run a lot of their server infrastructure through containers these days. So if you pay somebody with PayPal, as far as I'm aware, you are sending that through a container now. Interesting, huh? Well, let's think about this for a minute, shall we? The containers work so well because we've got Linux, an open source free operating system that we can put in these containers without having to deal with license fees and all that fun stuff. And we also have a host OS of Linux where these containers can run on top of actual bare metal hardware. So again, something to think about when it comes to containers. Another thing to think about when it comes to Linux, and this is something that I'm pretty sure I brought up in the last video, but it's still just such a big thing for me. I wanted to reiterate it again. The fact that you have ultimate control. I did a video recently talking about how you could customize the login screen using GDM3, the GNOME Display Manager version 3. This is the software that you use to type in your username and password, select which user that you want to log into, etc., etc., etc. And even what desktop you want to be launched into once that you log in. So I can actually put a company logo or a specific disclaimer message at the beginning when you log in, different things like that. Very customizable. I was talking to a friend about this a while back, and I know used to Windows, there was a way you could actually, if you had the right version, you could put in, I think you had to be connected to domain too. I'm really not clear on that. I'm not a big Windows person. I never really have been, really, but I think there was a way, I mean, there was some way I know, but I don't know how it worked exactly. You could set your like company logo or something on the Windows login screen, but I think they got rid of that after Windows 7. I was talking to a friend about this, and they brought it up, and I think that's the case. But anyway, regardless of that, Linux is very customizable. You can have the exact desktop environment you want. I actually really have been playing around and enjoying for the last about year a window manager. I don't use it constantly, but I use something called the Enhanced Motif Window Manager, which is a fork of the original Motif Window Manager from decades ago. And I have to say, I mean, you know, they've done some nice improvements. One thing they've done is make it to where that you can take something like Firefox or something and actually make it properly maximize. The old Motif Window Manager with newer programs, they're expecting things to be there that aren't. And so when you try to maximize things, it doesn't work. It will go off the screen part of the window, and it's just, you know. So, but I have to say, I mean, it's really interesting because, I mean, if you want a really lightweight system or a really, really nice, pretty system, you've got options both directions. You want something really light, go with a window manager, or if you're in the Wayland world, a compositor that's super, super lightweight. On the Wayland side, if you want to go lightweight, I like something called Wayfire. And it's actually very, very lightweight as well. So whether you're going Xorg or whether you're going Wayland, the reality of it is you can have a super, super lightweight system when it comes to RAM and CPU usage. And sometimes I may want a system that is not using very much resources. And quite frankly, I kind of like the look of the 90s UIs like the Motif Window Manager and the common desktop environment. Sure, you could argue they're ugly, but they're kind of one of those things that's ugly, but kind of in a nice way, if that makes any sense. Anyway, my point being is Linux is very customizable. Again, if you want a really, really nice looking desktop, get KDE Plasma, get GNOME 3. You know, you could get like Mote and customize. You could use XFCE and customize. You could use the Cinema desktop from the Linux Mint folks and customize. And the point is, like, there's a lot of flexibility here. Wayfire can look really good if you customize it as well. For those of you who didn't know, if you're using a Raspberry Pi, the Wayfire compositor is actually what is used right now if you're logging into a Raspberry Pi GUI with the default Raspberry Pi desktop environment. It is the baseline that they use under the hood. And I have to say, it's really nice, and I like it, and that's actually how I first found out about it. And anyway, I dug into it. You can use it on things that aren't Raspberry Pis as well, but their customizations are kind of nice little, you know, candy, if you will, on top of that. Now I want to go get some candy after I film this. But anyway, another thing I really, really like about Linux, and I mean, this is just a big one for me, it's just the fact that I can get what I want done in it without having to fight. You know, some operating systems that will remain nameless. Let's just say in my experience, you kind of have to babysit the OS. And to me, the OS's whole point is to get the heck out of my way and let me do my work. Let me have my fun. Whatever it is I'm trying to do with that computer system, that is what I want to do, right? And my goal is not to sit there and fight with the operating system. My goal is to say, well, I would like to play video game A. Let's go open up video game A. It loads, everything works. I'm happy, everything works, right? Or I could turn around and say the exact same thing, but instead of with a game, you know, it could be, well, I need to write some code. Let me open my code editor. It gets out of the way. I want to create a system service. You know, I put the right configuration files in place. It gets out of the way. It's just, it's a wonderful thing. And along with that, from a power standpoint, one thing that I really enjoy about Linux is that pretty much everything's config file based. So if you want to back up a Linux system and then be able to transplant those settings to another system, figure out where its configuration files are for that program, copy them into, you know, a tar file or whatever, move them over the network, and then extract them in the appropriate location. Start that program after you install it, and bingo, you should have, right, the same settings. It should look the same. All those things should be the case. And I mean, what more could you ask for than to be able to have a system where it's that easy to move things? I do this all the time where I'll take a config file, maybe not all the time, but some of the time, but I will take a config file and I'll say, you know, I would like this program to work the same on, you know, a computer in the other room, and just copy it, and you're done. You're done. It's so easy. So I just really like that workflow. It's just so nice. Another big thing for me when it comes to Linux is Bash and the command line. I mean, it's just so good. It's so good. I really like the command line. It lets me get everything I want done on most of it. I've got all kinds of custom Bash scripts and even Python programs I've written that work in the CLI to automate all kinds of things for me. And I just run a quick command and walk away, and all kinds of work gets done for me. If I want to put a video up on my website, I literally run a Bash script. It does all the conversion work for me. It puts it in MPEG dash. It shoots all of that up to the CDN for me. This is all automated. I give it two things. A folder where the video is and the captions. The video file has to be named a very specific thing, and the caption file has to be named a very specific thing. And then all I do is say, you know, that directory is where to find those. And then the second argument I give the script is, this is the video ID to put it under on the CDN. And that's it. It will do all the work of getting those videos into every single format that I want the video players to have available to them, all the different resolutions. You know, it would get the captions converted into the format that's necessary for web. I caption in the broadcast captioning format for those that are wondering, and therefore the web doesn't really support that in most cases. So, you know, I convert it to WebVTT. This is all automated. I run one command and I walk away, and 5 or 10 minutes later, whatever, my video is up on the CDN and I don't have to even think about it. There's something really nice to be said about that. Could you do that in Windows? Could you do that in Mac? Yes. But the fact Linux is free and you can run it on almost anything, and then you can have that script and you can replicate it on all these boxes, it's just so powerful. So everybody, I hope you enjoyed today's video. You know, I know it's a bit of a rambly one, and I know I've talked about some of this stuff before, but I hope to see you all again very soon. Goodbye, everybody. And action.